Hi, welcome to Talking Tech. I'm your host, Marcus Yam, and today we're talking about unlocking more gaming performance out of your Intel PC using an Intel software called Intel Application Optimization. To learn more about that, I need to talk to an expert engineer, and joining me once again is Intel Fellow Guy Therien. Guy, thanks for joining.
You're welcome, Marcus. Good to see you again.
Good to see you. Now, obviously those who have been following our conversations on processor binning and Intel Turbo Technologies, you need no introduction. But what I think needs a little bit of introduction today is the Intel Application Optimization software. So can you tell us, what is it and what does it do?
Okay, sure. The Intel Application Optimization software is a piece of software that we've developed that helps improve the performance of certain applications. Initially, we are improving the performance of gaming applications.
Okay, so why games specifically? And I think that the segment I know that cares a lot about performance are gamers. Is there anything more to it than that?
In this case, we typically get judged on multiple factors. Single-thread performance, multi-thread performance, gaming are typical factors that we get judged on. And when it comes to gaming, the gaming crown is judged on a whole bunch of gaming applications that are individually evaluated. And so there is an opportunity across those gaming titles to improve their performance and be judged, hopefully, more competitive.
Okay, so to talk about performance, can you give us an idea of like the range of performance increases we're getting through application optimization software, or APO? Let's just make it easier on ourselves. We call it APO.
Sure.
What can people expect when running this software?
Sure. So in general, people feel that a few percent of improvement of any score of anything is can be in the noise. So we judge the benefit that we'd like to target in order to offer support for any individual title by having at least a few percent of performance, and in some cases up to maybe 10, 20 or more percent performance.
Well, that's significant, and you're talking about a few percent. Now, I know enthusiasts out there, myself included, even overclocking, a few percent is worth chasing. So to get something like this, essentially for free, this is free software available in the Windows Store, that's a pretty big bonus. Before we go further though, this is not a mutually exclusive optimization. People can still overclock their systems and get some of the gains there, as well as run APO at the same time, is that right?
That's very true. In fact, Intel Application Optimization is really focusing on optimizing the processor performance as opposed to the game, the graphics card performance. So the best graphics cards need to be fed by the processor. So when the gaming applications is running, it's feeding the graphics. Okay? And so what we're doing is we're optimizing the processor side, the CPU side of the performance, so it can feed the best graphics.
So there's been this speculation, and maybe it's a misconception, that all APO does is it just disables the E cores and just lets the P cores run and do their full thing. Is that the way it works?
Not at all.
Okay, so how does it work then?
What it's doing is it's optimizing the game's use of the resources in the processor, right? The SoC, so it can feed the graphics optimally.
And how does that affect? What's the relationship between the performance there and graphics?
So the better that you feed the graphics, the higher the frame rate. The graphics doesn't have to wait to get the next piece of work to achieve. So it's feed, 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 and then the graphics can do its job and produce a frame rate.
And this is true regardless of whether it's third-party discrete graphics or Intel Arc, it's the same thing.
That's right, so, except that different graphics implementations have different performance capabilities. And so when the graphics are the fastest, that's when the CPU needs to shine in order to feed it.
And just so we don't lose this point, because I got another question in my mind,
okay,
to follow up on this. But so to be clear, the E cores are still enabled. They can do their thing, whether you're streaming, recording, those things that the E cores are really good at, those are still present when APO is on.
That's right. Those resources are there available to use for background tasks, streaming, anything else. It's just in certain situations, the application optimization software controls resources that are used by games to make them optimally perform.
Now you mentioned the combination of different graphics, whether it's third party or Intel Arc graphics. You said there's different validation and combinations. So can you talk more about what does it mean to have APO validated on like a 14th gen system with different graphics? What kind of work goes into making sure that these combinations of hardware work?
Sure. So as I mentioned, when we deliver this application optimization, we have a targeted minimum kind of gain we'd like to see. And that gain is what we put in for any titles that are supported for a given SKU. And in the application optimization UI, you'll see the titles listed that have been validated to work with a specific SKU. And the SKU may include a graphics card by one of the leading graphics vendors, or it could be internal graphics. And we have to check all those combinations of the titles, the SKUs, and the graphics type in order to decide what to offer as supported or validated in the default configuration for application optimization. Because all the combinations don't deliver the same result. And like I said, the top end, their best graphics card actually benefit the most from what we do in our application optimization software.
And just like the way people can build their PCs from different parts, there's almost a countless number of configurations that you must
lots of permutations, that's right. And so it's very time consuming and resource intensive in order to validate all those.
And for validated, what do you mean by validated platforms? Is this validated on 14-inch NPCs? What's the range of validation?
So by default, the initial Intel application optimization software supported 14th-gen PCs. This was first launched back in October of last year. And that means that we have our criteria, as I mentioned, a few percent benefit in frames per second or more with certain titles and certain graphics configurations. And so when we say we validated it for the SKUs that we support, you'll get that benefit for those combinations of processor, graphics, and SKU.
And that was at the launch time of APO in October. But I know that, you know, Intel takes community feedback to heart. So what about those who've been asking about APO support on 12th gen or 13th gen systems?
Yeah, so it's true. There was some feedback where people really wanted it to be available on previous generation systems, specifically the hybrid generations. And so given that feedback, we looked at what was possible to be done. And we decided to offer something that we call advanced mode. And in advanced mode, we allow the end user to try any title that we have seen benefit on some SKU graphics combination on their specific implementation. It might not be the exact thing that we've validated has benefit, but it could be a 12th generation or 13th generation with a different kind of graphics card, and they can try to see if they can get benefit and they like it. And if so, they can leave it enabled, and if not, they can disable it either entirely or per title.
Great, and that's, you know, advanced mode is for the advanced user who's willing to take kind of their own system performance into their own hands, just like what we say for overclocking.
That's right.
So 12th and 13th gen in the advanced tab. Is there anything else that these users may need to do? Again, of course, they're taking their own system destiny into their own hands, but is it just available as a get-go when they're in the advanced tab, or what else might they need to do?
Well, in order to get Intel application optimization to work on the 12th and 13th gen systems, the first thing is that there needs to be a device exposed by the channel ODMs or ODMs in order to have that driver loaded on there. Okay? So that might require a BIOS update for previous generation systems. Once that BIOS update is available and applied, then a device driver will be needed for that device that's exposed. This driver will typically come from the channel motherboard ODM or the platform OEM. Once that driver is then loaded, then the features and capabilities will be available.
And of course, that's great that this feedback is taken from the community, but to reiterate, all the work that's being done validating 14th gen platforms now mean that anyone building a 14th gen or who has a 14th gen system, from a channel vendor, from an OEM, from a system integrator, 14th gen is supported and validated right from the get-go. No need for the advanced tab, is that right?
That's right.
So we've talked a lot about the performance benefits for APO in terms of more frames per second. Are there any other ancillary benefits to APO?
It turns out that there are. Specifically, in some cases, there's a power reduction. So as I mentioned earlier, what we're doing with Intel application optimization is to optimize the use of processor resources. And in some cases, processor resources could be wasted by applications who are not optimally coded. And so in this case, when we optimize those applications, we get a reduction in that wasted work, as well as the performance upside. So in some cases, we actually get higher frames per second and lower power.
That's pretty cool. Is it even significant enough to influence the thermal characteristics so the processor can maintain a higher frequency for longer?
For sure. That's right. That's the part. It's like a combination benefit.
Yeah, I remember our conversation on Turbo. So that's where that came from.
Right. So we get the optimization benefit from optimizing the software. That reduces the power, and that allows higher frequency.
Very, very cool. Sorry for the pun. So you've talked a lot about how APO works under the hood. And you talked about enabling, disabling per title. Let's talk about how APO works for the user, right? Now you've given us a little bit of a dive into how it works under the hood, but let's say someone's just downloaded this from the Windows Store. What should they expect when they open up the application?
Okay, so first thing I need to tell you is that by default, Intel Application Optimization does not require any UI.
Oh, okay.
Right. It is a driver-based solution. If the motherboard or the platform exposes that driver, the driver is downloaded from the manufacturer's website, and the application optimization just automatically works. Okay. If they want to see what titles are being configured, or they want to enter the advanced mode, then the Windows Store application is required.
So in October, APO launched with a smaller set of titles than are available today. As new titles are added, how did those get added to APO?
APO is a driver, as I said, and a new device driver is available, and it can be updated.
I see. And is there any difference in what's supported between, let's say, a desktop system and a mobile HX system?
Yes, that's a good question. Desktop systems are typically what we consider non-power constrained, but mobile systems do have much more power constraints, and the number of titles and graphics combinations that provide value change because of those conditions. So it's often the case that optimizing a mobile system is different than optimizing a desktop system.
That makes sense. Especially for validation, there's only a finite number of configurations you can have in a mobile system compared to the nearly endless.
All the adding cards and things exactly. That you can do for desktop, yeah.
So how does APO end up on someone's system? Do they just download it and it's on? How do people know that it's working without having to run before and after benchmarks, or is it even possible?
Sure. So fundamentally, Intel Application Optimization is system software, and it's a driver. And device drivers are exposed on platforms, and they require drivers. Windows will give what we call a yellow bang in the system if it doesn't have a driver for it. So in order to keep that from happening, you need to download and get a driver. And in this case, this device and this driver, including the Intel Application Optimization, install and automatically start working for the game set that's been validated for the specific platform.
So if that's the case, how do I know it's even there?
Okay. So if you want to find out if it's actually there and working, besides trying to uninstall it and run the game and see if you get the performance, that's when you need the UI. This comes from the Windows Store. And that UI, when it initializes, it tries to communicate to the driver, and it will tell you if it cannot. And that's how you know if it's actually functioning.
So users shouldn't really be surprised if they install APO and they open up the UI and they see that one of the titles that they play is already enabled.
All titles are enabled by default. So for a platform, for any specific platform, all validated titles for that platform graphics combination are by default enabled.
Okay, and so, but the UI also gives the user, you know, freedom to disable, enable on a per title basis.
Right, either all the features and capabilities of APO or on a per title basis.
So if this gives a performance uplift, why even have the ability to turn it off?
In some cases, it's possible for a game title to be updated, and it then might be something that we haven't validated with. As a result, there may be a case where the performance of a specific gaming title could invert with Intel Application Optimization. While I haven't seen that yet, it's still possible. I mean, we want to provide a capability for the end user to disable for any individual title as a remedy.
That's really smart. So instead of waiting for yet another update to fix some sort of inversion, right away, that user can just disable on a single title and, you know, get back to the performance that is better in their case.
Yes, that's right. And hopefully we'll catch it next time with the next update. But of course, those updates come at all different times and they are independent of our validation schedule.
So you're talking about next updates. What is next and upcoming for APO?
Well, thanks for asking. Of course, we will continue to look at features and capabilities within Intel Application Optimization to deliver benefit. And we are aspirational to expand titles, and we're aspirational to expand the capability beyond gaming in the future as we derive benefit, see benefit through the things that we can configure. We'll deliver that benefit in a future release.
Well, Guy, as always, it's such a pleasure to talk about getting more performance out of our Intel processors. So once again, thank you for talking tech.
Thanks for having me.